Seven. I want good news. That's an order.
Then I must disobey. I have no good news to report.
Meditation, it rejuvenates you.
Indeed it does.
I suggest you try Borg regeneration. It's much more efficient. A simple cortical implant would be required.
Another time, perhaps.
Dr. Chaotica had escaped, but he left behind his trusty robot to foil Captain Proton.
My designation.
Ah, right. You're Constance Goodhart. You're my secretary.
Secretary.
Where did it come from?
Lieutenant Belana Torres, chief engineer, Klingon human hybrid. She possesses extensive knowledge of this vessel's systems, as well as a volatile temperament.
My, look at the size of that thing. This view screen. It's gotta be one of the biggest I've ever seen. I'll give you 20 bars of platinum for it.
I think the inhibitor's gone offline. Would you come here, please?
Be quiet! Can't you see I'm in the middle of a deal? Name your price.
Captain... Janeway. And you are?
Damon Torot.
You're Ferengi.
Of course I'm Ferengi. Is that some kind of insult about the size of my ears?
Seven. Move over by the helm. I want to get a group shot.
I'm busy.
I'm bored. Let's do something fun.
Citizen of Earth, surrender. Do not resist.
I am Borg.
Surrender.
The robot has been neutralized. May I leave now?
Come on, Seven. Give it a chance. The galaxy's at stake.
You have exceeded expectations.
Then expectations were insufficient.
A simple thank you would suffice.
We've been treating you several days, remember?
No.
Short-term memory loss, it's one of the symptoms. Don't worry, it isn't life-threatening, but we'll need to treat you in sickbay.
What is this treatment gonna cost me?
It's free of charge.
Free?
Yes.
You know, I have been having a nagging pain in my lower left lobe. And while you're at it, why don't you run a complete tricardial diagnostic? The Ferengi Health Commission's trying to revoke my trading license. Is this chair occupied? Yes or no would suffice.
No. I mean, yes.
Explain.
You can't sit here. Somebody else is sitting here.
Very well. The species intends to purge our galaxy of all life. It's time you resisted your Starfleet philosophy.
Anything new?
Every scan reveals something new, but as yet little of relevance.
You seem uncomfortable taking orders from me.
It's just that I'm used to taking orders from Belana, that's all. And to tell you the truth, she
doesn't like me, yes, I am aware of that. However, the captain left me in charge during Lieutenant Torres' absence. Her feelings about me are irrelevant.
Resistance is futile.
Perhaps.
Three direct hits.
They're losing attitude control, they're pulling up.
Nice shooting, Seven.
Seven?
My visual processors and motor cortex. They are malfunctioning.
Sounds like a problem with your cortical implant. We'd better have a look. Hold still.
I cannot comply.
You're intoxicated.
Impossible.
Your blood synthahol level is 0.05%. How many glasses of champagne did you consume?
One.
Obviously the Borg can't hold their liquor. Come to sickbay. I'll give you some inoproline to counteract the effects.
Ah, Bosun. Ready to shove off?
What are you talking about, Lieutenant?
Call me Skipper.
Sailor talk. You'll get used to it.
I think not. Naomi Wildman, subunit of Ensign Samantha Wildman. State your intentions.
Seven?
It is in my nature to comply with the collective.
Impressive vessel, Captain. Galaxy class?
Intrepid.
Ah! And here we are in the much talked about sick bay. Not exactly state of the medical art now, is it?
What do you mean?
Low on bio beds. Terrible lighting. Obsolete instruments. Lucky for you, I know a medical supplier that can spruce this place up in a nanosecond. And I'll even drop my commission to a mere 30%.
How generous of you. Ooh. Computer, activate force field.
Force field? You said I wasn't contagious.
It's
7 of 9. How's my favorite Borg today?
Annoyed.
I was just observing you.
Explain.
Well, Neelix told me that the Borg do a lot of things they do because they're trying to be perfect. And even though you're not really a drone anymore, you still try to be perfect, don't you?
Correct.
Well, if I can learn to be perfect too, then Captain Janeway will have to make me her bridge assistant.
No such rank exists aboard this vessel.
Not yet.
And you hope to achieve this goal by emulating me.
Are you mad?
No. There are many on this crew that would benefit from your example.
You realize it will reduce our chance of getting through.
Chance is irrelevant. We will succeed.
I was simply trying to perfect my social skills, as you instructed me to do.
And you're doing a fine job.
You have always been of enormous assistance to me, Doctor. You are my mentor.
Yes.
We are as one. We are as one.
You adapt.
Adapt?
You know, like the Borg.
Borg, I hate Borgs.
You do?
Yeah, they're mean.
I'm still holding out for a diplomatic solution.
Improbable. Species 8472 will not respond to diplomacy.
Funny, we used to say the same thing about the Borg.
Good morning.
That remains to be seen. These are star charts for the next 3 systems Voyager will pass through. Familiarize yourself with them.
Understood.
Sociological data regarding 173 Delta Quadrant species. Study it.
I will.
As bridge assistant, you will find this information relevant.
Consider it assimilated.
It seems your infantile scenario now poses a security risk.
It's just supposed to be a little harmless entertainment.
Entertainment? Another frivolous human endeavor.
7?
I'm sorry. The Borg have changed as well. I expected re-assimilation, not conversation.
Congratulations.
For what?
You may not want to know.
My mom says 2 heads are better than 1. Isn't that the Borg philosophy too?
Simplistic, but accurate.
I'm married. I'm not going into stasis for the rest of my life. No, I plan to
I do not wish to be dependent on anyone. By marrying, one limits one's romantic interactions to a single individual. A circumstance which implies extreme monotony.
I'm glad we had this little talk.
How do you propose we adapt?
You are the Borg, you tell me.
Captain, target the power node directly above this alcove. It will disrupt her command interface.
Our thoughts are one. It's Hazari. Species 4228. Technologically advanced, extremely violent. They make excellent tactical drones.
Seven, how'd you do that?
I scanned the device. Its mechanism operates on a simple fractal regression.
You scanned it? That's cheating.
Cheating is often more efficient. I didn't think Vulcans believed in luck.
As a rule, we don't. But serving with Captain Janeway has taught me otherwise.
She does seem to succeed more often than random chance would allow. I have been observing you as part of my research on human mating behavior.
Stardate 52647, 1400 hours. Subjects quarrel in corridor outside female's quarters. Male returns with 12 flowering plant stems, species Rosa rubifolia, effecting a cessation of hostilities. Stardate 52648, 0300 hours, intimate relations resume. How the hell do you know when we're having intimate relations?
There is no one on Deck 9, Section 12, who doesn't know when you're having intimate relations.
You're a woman, Seven.
Is that an observation or a diagnosis?
Your first date.
I've narrowed the list to 2 crewmen, based on work performance and compatible interests.
I didn't know you had any interests.
Neither did I, but apparently they include astronomy, quantum mechanics, and music.
I play the clarinet, you know.
You are not one of the candidates, Ensign. It's all right, Doctor. I believe he is merely engaging in small talk. May I get either of you gentlemen a drink?
Yes, gin and tonic with a twist.
You know I don't drink. I don't have the stomach for it.
A well-crafted joke, Doctor.
I've studied human mating rituals.
Move your hand or I will remove your arm.
But small talk is a vital dating skill. It helps to establish a rapport with your companion.
Perhaps there's something to be said for assimilation, after all.
I don't think we've met.
Jameson, Anna, service number 860790.
I'm not security. I just trying to get to know all the new faces around here. What are you working on?
I am attempting to realign the EPS manifold.
Do you need a hand?
No.
Well, maybe I'll see you in the mess hall later.
Unlikely.
Hello?
May I buy you a drink?
Sure. Stephen Price. And you are?
Seven of Nine, tertiary adjunct. You may call me Seven. I'm experiencing dizziness, double vision. After considering all potential environmental and genetic factors, I've concluded that I am suffering from Albright-Saltzman syndrome.
A rare neurological condition that hasn't affected a single human being for over two centuries. Unlikely.
Human physiology is imperfect, susceptible to a variety of disorders.
Where are you going?
Our small talk is terminated. I have mastered this exercise. We can proceed to the next.
We'll start with hobbies. What do you do with your spare time?
Regenerate.
Uh-huh. Tell me about your tastes, your likes and dislikes.
I dislike irrelevant conversations.
Okay. Which brings us to goals. What do you want out of life?
Perfection.
Well, I guess I'll have to tell B'Elanna that you thought you couldn't beat her.
You're attempting to appeal to my vanity.
Is it working?
I will consider your request.
It's yes or no, Seven. The tournament's tonight.
Yes.
You look beautiful.
Thank you. You look beautiful as well.
A Borg? I've never seen one outside the collective.
I am an individual now. You may address your comments to me. I am uncertain how to wear such a garment. Assist me.
Oh, I'm sure you'll manage.
Garson.
Server, report to this station. We require your assistance.
2 years before you joined the crew, when the ship was under attack.
Species 329, the Kazon.
Our database indicates that Voyager was boarded twice during that period.
The Kazon are an inferior species. They don't possess the technology to create such a complex weapon. This creature has an exoskeleton.
It's a lobster. They're a delicacy on Earth. Try it.
Seven of Mine.
It may be possible to encode some of my nanoprobes to assimilate the synthahol molecules.
Assimilate me.
There may be some adverse effects.
Please.
Try to relax. You seem a little tense.
Relaxation would disrupt my chronographic sequencer. It allows me to maintain synchronous movement with the music. The Borg once traveled back in time to stop Zefram Cochrane from breaking the warp barrier. They succeeded, but that in turn led the starship Enterprise to intervene. They assisted Cochrane with the flight the Borg were trying to prevent. Causal loop complete.
So, in a way, the Federation owes its existence to the Borg.
You're welcome.
Medical emergency.
I intend to suffer third-degree plasma burns during our encounter with the mines. Explain. No time. You must apprehend him. He's trying to destroy Voyager.
Seven of Nine, status.
I am incapacitated. It's sensory aphasia.
Stand by. I'm pulling you out.
Stop him. Your future depends on it. My first date was certainly short.
Was that a joke?
Lesson six, beguiling banter.
You said you want to learn more about humanity. I guess we're not exactly prized examples. I'm sorry.
On the contrary, you've taught me a great deal.